down the floor. Evansville does the same type of thing.
slow motion. That looks like that ball's coming down.
That's a goaltend.
But not the call. Evansville will get out of bounds. It's an advantage seeing it three times in slow motion.
Even seeing it one time in fast motion, I thought it was goaltend. I thought Coach Cruz had an excellent drive. Easy basket. Stuart Sullivan beats Gutton inside on the out-of-bounds play. And the Evansville lead now is three. Not only gets beat, but they get beat for a layup right under the basket. I don't understand how you can get beat for a layup. This is the second time Evansville's come out of a timeout. They've gotten a layup.
Talked about free throws important for both teams. Evansville has taken 14 free throws. This will be Indiana's sixth attempt.
Well, I think the more aggressive team is going to get to the line more often. And so far, Evansville has been by far the much more aggressive team out there today.
One of the keys to our game. So Evansville has a 10-5 lead at that free throw line, and still they're 2 points down. Watch that stat the rest of the game. Hollander with only 4 points here early. Now on the Evansville bench. And Indiana leads it by three. 1:40 left, first half.
Back to my point as far as Evansville. When they get the ball, I think their guys are looking to drive to the basket, create problems for the defense. Morales, he's looking either to score or to pass over here to Rising. Watch Sullivan.
Lewis. AJ Guyton gets the start instead of Lewis.
You can see really pushing Collier down low. He really did a nice job. You can see Indiana basically taking everybody to one side of the floor. They're putting Guyton and they're putting Collier down low, and they're just gonna play a little two-man game until Evansville comes over and starts double-teaming Collier. I'm sure you're gonna see that.
Bob Knight pleased with that first move by Collier as he got the ball, quickly moved to the hoop.
Jimmy Morales really leaning hard on Collier right there. I think Collier will be much more comfortable playing now that Morales is out of there. I think sometimes it's much more difficult for a big guy to play with a little 6'6", 6'7", guy on you than it is a bigger guy.
Morales picked up that third foul at 109 left in the first half, and now the first 23 seconds of the half, he's picked up his fourth. Collier misses on both free throws, so Indiana can't capitalize. Now Evansville has possession.
There's no change in what Evansville is trying to do. And you can see Collier, they're going to call a foul right here. They're going to call him for a push.
And that's his fourth. So just as we talked about Morales, Collier picks his fourth up. And Richard Mandeville will check in for him. He's got to be careful here not to pick that fifth one up.
It'll be interesting if we get a chance to see Richardson falls down on the baseline. Just how much of a foul Collier created. Great play.
Steal by Collier.
Got to watch out or he'll get number five.
He goes right over Richardson. He's going to get the hoop and a foul. I tell you, that's a gutsy play for the freshman.
That is a really gutty play. I mean, he makes a great steal, great anticipation, but then he takes it almost three quarters of the length floor. Watch him right here. Good anticipation right there. Now he comes up with the ball. He sees the guy. He says, heck with it, I'm going for it. You can see Richardson doesn't ever get set, similar to what Reed did earlier in the game. Kind of moving up under Collier as he takes the ball to the basket.
Missed on the free throw chance, but still gives Indiana the 8-point lead.
Your coach would have liked to have seen Collier hit that free throw, not only to get the point, but also to get him out of there with four fouls.
He's still in the game. Drive, Patterson on the defense, and he draws the foul. Quinn will go to the line.
Personal foul.
Quinn really got caught in between right there. He got caught in between dribbles. He almost traveled, but Andre Patterson kind of moved into him, bailed him out. Evansville gets the ball out of bounds.
Won't be a shooting foul, so Evansville does have it out of bounds. Layden, a good inbounds play again, misses a shot.
Good inbounds play, but terrible defense by Indiana, just giving up a little 4 or 5 footer, a shot that Evansville should hit. You can see they get Sullivan holding Neil Reed, coming off another good solid screen by Richard Mandeville.
Reed hasn't been scoring a lot, but he hasn't been in position really, and that Sullivan had to hold him that time. Now Layton comes out, and 34, Kurt Begel in.
This is the kind of game Neil Reed could score a lot of points in the last 15 minutes, not only getting open inside, but shooting a lot of free throws. If Evansville continues to hold here, Indiana's going to go to the free throw line. Guyton
on that outside shot is off. Hollander bringing it up.
It's a little bit off. It's almost like the Princeton. I saw Princeton, Evansville not as good at it as Princeton was. You can see once again Hollander gets caught up off the floor, but Princeton excellent at spreading the floor on you, pass, make a cut, drive to the basket, dish off, and Evansville has been very good at it today.
Charlie Miller with that steal, and Patterson stepped on the line. He got the ball where he wanted, but it ended up too far underneath the basket, stepped on the line.
Well, he got double teamed. Good job by Evansville to come down and double team. Indiana had a chance really to get two easy points right there, but Evansville really doing a nice job with body positioning on defense. They're not giving up the block.
Here's Bagel. Here's Quinn, quick move on Patterson. Now dishes back out. Shot clock's at 11. Sullivan, very quick inside. Got around two big guys and lays it in.
Good drive.
Sullivan with 4 points, and the lead 6 now for Indiana. Inside, Mandeville had position. And the foul on Bagel.
Personal foul.
Take a look at the last play by Evansville. You can see a great drive by Sullivan. Knifes inside, able to get the finger roll. Excellent offense by Evansville, doing exactly what Coach Cruz has set up. Out of bounds play, nearly stolen. Miller comes away with it. Here's Reed and Patterson working. Miller will take that shot.
Little confidence. Do I see a little confidence right there? Coach Knight and Dockage both calling for the three. I think they only gave him two.
They did for his 9 point. Now Miller
great defensive
comes over.
Play.
He makes the steal and no advantage on the break. Again, Mandeville open now. Bagel went down and Mandeville up on the layup.
He could miss that.
As Evansville again tried to draw the charge, and that left Mandeville wide open.
See, Coach still yelling at Eric Harmon about the three. I'm sure he'd like to yell at Richard Mandeville also. Not getting that easy 2 points.
Evansville still patient. Mandeville picks up the foul, and that'll be his four.
Really bail him out right there. There's no place for Sullivan to go. And Mandeville just runs right out there and bumps into him. They're still talking about the three. Eric Harmon saying, did you guys see it? Coach Knight wanting an answer.
He's at the midcourt as the referees talk about it. With the big guys, both Collier and Mandeville each have four fouls. So Harris, also a crowd favorite, gets a hand
okay,
as he
let's
comes
take
in.
A look at Charlie Miller. Was he behind the line? Oh, yes, he was. That's a three. There's no question about it. You can see the first guy to jump up off the bench was Coach Dockage. Dan Dockage knew right away that it was a three. A lot of people might be wondering whether or why Harris has not been in the game. Harris has had the flu or whatever this flu is that the people have had. He's had a very tough with the respiratory system.
Score just changed. Indiana now with 40, so they are going to give 41. They give Charlie Miller that 3-point shot.
Coach Cruz not very happy about it, as I'm sure you wouldn't expect him to be.
And a jump ball as Quinn tried to go up with it. And he is way out on the floor now, and he does have a technical foul called as he felt Quinn got fouled there, and that is the second one.
So there's Eric Harmon. Jim Cruz has been tossed from this game.
This could be a real change right here. I mean, Indiana will get four free throws and the ball out of bounds.
I think the first technical was called as Jim was down on the baseline, and the second one as the official came up near the coach's box.
Well, you can see, I mean, more than anything, it's not just that play. It's a lot of frustration. I mean, he feels like Indiana's getting a few calls here and there. They've changed the score. I mean, it was a good change by the officials. It definitely was a three-pointer. His feet were behind the line. Indiana called it to their attention. He got the three, but there's a number of things building up to it right here, and then the play down on the baseline where he felt like Chris Quinn should have gotten the foul call. You can see Indiana's got about three guys around him.
And here, let's take a look at the foul. Quinn gets the ball inside.
So you got three guys around him right here. Right here, Andre Patterson really slapping down at the ball. He does have his right hand on the ball right there. There's no question, but I think they felt like he got him other ways. And you can see the official there's nothing he can do. I mean, Coach Cruz has met him halfway out there on the floor by that time. You got to call the technical.
Reed hits two in a row, and the lead all of a sudden is now 11, and he has two more to go.
Sometimes it's interesting to see how a team will react once their coach, something like that happens. I mean, this has been a very tough, hard-playing Evansville team. They have given a tremendous effort out here as Neil Reed knocks down four in a row.
There's Steve Bennett, assistant coach. He'll take over, and he wants a 20-second timeout. So Neil Reed hits four free throws, and all of a sudden it's a 13-point lead for Indiana. And here the crowd, mostly the Evansville fans, not happy with how that's gone.
scores from some other games earlier today. Oklahoma, the big win over the Boilers. And Illinois with a big lead over UCLA. Ball State with a victory over Northeast Louisiana. There's Steve Bennett. He's been with Jim Crews a long time.
I think it's a really good timeout call. We use that 20-second timeout call right there to really gather his team. You know, there's no reason they can't play as well the rest of the game as they've played up to this point.
So the lead now 13, Indiana's biggest on those four technical free throws by Neil Reed. We'll see how those technicals affect either team. Here's Miller.
Good offense by Indiana to get an excellent shot. Charlie Miller starting to play with more confidence. He's coming off screens, doing things the way that Charlie Miller should do them.
Now 11 from Miller. And A.J. Guyton gets beat that time. Richardson on the drive.
Guyton with the body check right there.
And now a timeout. 15:36 left. It's Indiana by 15 as they try to extend this lead. 9-2 run since this second half began. There's Steve Bennett, longtime assistant at Evansville. He'll be the head man the rest of the way in. So a good start to this second half for Indiana. Extending their lead now to 15 points. Hollander outside for three is off.
Good aim by
Guyton. The other way.
Able to come up with that rebound. Almost got over his head. See right there. Now that's the type of thing that you like to see him do. He wasn't able to get the basket, but he moved to the basket and really puts a lot of pressure on the defense.
Hollander cuts in from behind. Larry Richardson now in the game, draws the foul. Boy, Evansville sees the floor well. All their players know where their teammates are.
Yeah, that time Chris Hollander makes he makes a great drive, but then he gets caught watching the defense. Now watch how he watches the defense and he forgets to put the ball in the basket. Look at him, he was looking right at Larry Richardson. If he just goes up strong, he gets the foul and the basket. And at this point in time, they need three rather than two.
6'6" junior. He had 15 against Michigan State earlier this week.
They do an excellent job of spreading the floor and then finding the open people. As soon as you, a defensive man, you turn your back, that guy will make a cut to the basket. And today they've done an excellent job of reading the defense.
He's good on the second. Indiana now by 14.
Really taking Indiana. Good steal right there. Bad pass by Reed.
Hollander
lays it in.
Goes all the way in.
Really taking Neil Reed out of the Indiana offense. I mean, he just, other than hitting a few free throws here and there, he has just been non-existent.
Larry Richardson is the low now, trying to post up on Quinn. Really congested in there as Harris, Richardson, and Miller all work the 3 second lane.
Indiana got some very poor ball handlers in there right now. Larry Richardson, not a guy that probably Indiana wants to handle the ball, nor Harris Muzinovic.
Reed tries a three, it comes right back to him.
Nothing down there, you got to get it out of there.
New shot clock.
This is a team where Charlie Miller, Neil Reed, or A.J. Guyton have got to score points. You can see right there. Now A.J. that time goes to the basket. Early in the game, we talked about him catching the ball out top and doing nothing but looking to pass. When you put pressure on the defense and you go to the basket, now you're going to create some problems for the defense. Especially when you have the quickness of A.J. Guyton.
15 foul now and third on Richardson. So he comes out. Marcus Wilson back in.
Only two fouls away from the 1-1, and there's still over 14 minutes left in the game.
Robbie Eggers also in. Richardson comes to the bench. And in Evansville has it out of bounds underneath. Let's see.
The unsportsmanlike technical count as part of the team foul.
So there's only five team fouls, but because of the two technical fouls, they do count as team fouls. That makes it seven, and now Indiana, with over 14 minutes left in the game, is in the 1-1.
Officials caught that one with some help from the scorer's table. So Indiana is in the bonus and gotten at the line.
Yeah,
And this is where Guyton and Reed need to understand that this is when you start taking the ball to the basket, really putting a lot of pressure on the Evansville defense. It'll also open up your big men for some easier baskets inside.
Guyton is good on both. He now has seven, and he meets Wilson right at the 10-second line.
Post up by Hollander. He's got Reed on him.
Charlie Miller slapped that one away.
I don't know how Charlie got a hand on that, but I would think they would really want to take advantage of Hollander and Reed. I would think Hollander would get down on the post and tell everybody, clear out, let me have some of this.
Several switches since then, and Reed was off of Hollander. Bagel misses and tipped out of bounds. Indiana ball.
Bagel just got a hand on it, not able to come up with it, just tipped it out.
So it's Reed and Guyton, Charlie Miller, Harris Mujezinovic, and Robbie. in Madison Square Garden came at about the 3 minute mark and worked their way till Wilson hit a bank shot with under 5 seconds and gave Evansville the lead.
Well, the reasons that they will be able to come back is because Indiana gives them that opportunity to take some bad shots. They get some quick, fast break points. Indiana doesn't run very effectively in offense.
Andre inside. This time the left-hander goes in and a foul.
But the difference, lads, in the last two sequences is the patience. I mean, so many times Indiana comes down the floor, boom, they bring it to the side, and they think, okay, we're supposed to get it inside, bang, they throw it in there. This time, great, great pass by Lewis, great catch, Lewis goes up strong, gets fouled. Indiana's the patience. I mean, they've worked it around. body wise, but Charlie comes down. You can see he gets all ball right there, but it's hard to see whether he got him with the body, maybe down on the hip.
At the free throw line, number 15.
Charlie's been much more active today, much more in the flow of the game. He's not thinking, he's much more reacting to what's going on the floor.
James good on that free throw. He's also from Lawrence North High School by way of Trinidad. Get the herky jerky style of the line. Very flat trajectory. Watch this. Lean to the right. And both of them. And he did get both of them. Full court pressure now by Wilson. And a foul. I blew it from him.
To get himself more involved in the game offensively and become a threat. If he's not a threat outside, it makes it tough on Indiana.
Collier misses, but Charlie Miller right there for the tip-in. 15 for Miller.
That's the shot right there you'd like to really see Jason swing that left-handed jump hook. Bowling fans out there.
Scramble for the ball. Evansville's got it. Wilson with the layup.
Marcus Wilson.
That's the one when Jason catches it down there on that side of the floor that you'd like to see him swing that little jump hook rather than the jump shot, because when he plays against anybody, it's a very quick jumper. You go up against Taylor at Michigan, and he's going to throw that into about the fourth row.
Indiana trying to set the offense up. Miller's high. Now he pulls up inside. Collier comes outside.
His best game. He was much more into the flow of the game and just played much better than we've seen him play all year.
James moving inside, a travel. Collier stayed with him. 21 turnovers now for Evansville. So the pressure by Indiana's defense has led to many of those and really has controlled this game. A 20-point lead now for the Hoosiers. Double team, Jimenez. Richardson up quickly for the layup.
He didn't try to dunk that one last. Huh? He's had like two or three misses this year. He just laid it in and
powered that one in.
Oh, yeah.
Bagel outside off. Collier with the board. So Indiana now goes to 10-1 on the season. And they don't have much time till Monday night. They're
Down 12 seconds. Wilson with that jumper, so two threes here to end this game for Evansville. Lewis coming up, 5 seconds. Jean Paul off. And